so much for the question. If you look at the entire oil and gas process, not only in Kenya but across the world, I think it is a process which is shrouded in secrecy. Like in my community, for example, you find that when Tullow Oil, an Irish company, struck oil in Turkana County in 2011, they entered into deals, agreements and leases and all that with the national government in Nairobi. So they come to the local community and they don't want to engage the local community because they allege they have already talked to the president, the minister for the energy and other community leaders in Nairobi. So you find the kind of conflict arising between the oil company and the community on community participation in the oil and gas process, creating conflict in the future. And I remember I actually worked with the oil company for a month when it first did oil and gas exploration. And the reason why I left the oil company was because I was victimized. I worked for the oil company after signing an agreement, a contract as an employee of carrying out oil and gas exploration, moving around my place, which is very insecure because we fight over resources with the neighboring communities. And then after working for a whole month, and I signed a contract of around $500, I was given $20 by the oil company. And I was told the only reason why I couldn't get the money I had signed for was because it was too much. And that is blatant disregard of the law. And when these guys come to the community, they promise heaven on earth. They come to the community and they tell them, do you know something called the corporate social responsibility? We will take the likes of Ekai to universities to study masters. We will build schools. We will build hospitals, roads, and this insecurity you talk about on daily basis here will disappear. And you give them the consent after they promise you that, but when they begin operations, they do exactly the opposite of what they promised. If they promise it to build a school, they build no school. If they promise it to build 100 dispensaries or hospitals, they build zero. And this is something which is happening across the world, not just in Kenya, but all over the world. And there are so many options available for local communities like those in my village to be able to get power and avoid the destructive oil and gas process or charcoal burning. One major example is I live in a community which is blessed with a lot of sun. So we can tap into the sun and the solar power and generate a lot of electricity and even pipe it to other parts of Kenya. So we can avoid the destructive oil and gas process, the destructive blockage of rivers and production of electricity to the detriment of the local communities, and resort to clean and green sources of energy. And in that way, we can be able to save our planet. Because what is there is we are looking at development, and are we looking for development and ignoring human rights? So these human rights violations, like those which are happening in my place, in the name of development, have to stop because there are better alternatives existing. Thank you so much.